Just how many times can Liam Neeson make the exact same movie? I don't know, but I'm kind of game to find out, especially when he works with Jaume Collet-Serra. I really enjoyed one of their last collaborations, Nonstop, and also Run All Night was like a surprisingly good movie to, ironically enough, watch on a plane. And Jaume Collet-Serra, by the way, is the director that almost got Suicide Squad 2. Warner Brothers really wanted him, but not enough to sign him because he was still available for Disney to snatch up for their Dwayne Johnson star Jungle Cruise. I think Jaume Collet-Serra, by the way, is very, very good. I don't know if he's Jungle Cruise Suicide Squad sequel good, but I think that this kind of movie that we're about to watch the trailer for is his sweet spot. He could make it in his sleep. Liam Neeson could make it in his sleep. So let's see if this looks like they're sleepwalking. All right, here we go. It's got a good name. The Commuter.
Hey, kiddo.
I love you. Family. Everything's great.
It's my first time on a commuter train. What about you?
Every day. Last 10 years.
10 years? You must know everyone on this train.
I'm sorry. Have we met?
No, I'm Joanna.
Michael.
I study human behavior. My job is to answer one basic question.
What's that?
What kind of person are you?
Is this actually source code?
If I asked you to do something that could profoundly affect an individual on this train.
I don't understand.
Someone on this train does not belong. All you have to do is find them. In the bathroom, there is $75,000. That money is yours if you do this one little thing.
I thought this was hypothetical.
You have until next stop to decide. What kind of person are you?
Liam Neeson, damn it! I like that you checked to see if the money was there. It's like, I'm not doing this for free.
I'm not gonna do this. You tried to set me up.
No one forced you to take that money.
What's the importance of the money?
What do you want from me?
It's just one little thing.
A wedding ring, since you keep talking about it all the time? Eh, darn it, that was only medium. Poop. It was like they were just making it in their sleep. But I've seen so many movies, like, it did remind me a lot of Source Code. Source Code, I guess the ending of Source Code, like, really early on, but it was still a well-made movie, Duncan Jones. Directing, David Bowie's son, Jake Gyllenhaal, starring. I like Vera Farmiga in a role that I would think usually would go to a male actor, so that was kind of cool. I liked her fancy shoes, too. But I think, you know what my problem was? They didn't give me enough. I was like, okay, so now what? You know, like, they just were like, some crazy shenanigans are happening on this train, but thank goodness Liam Neeson's also on it. I mean, I don't know, I think it relied maybe too much on, like, you know, it relied too much on, like, outside references, so it just made me feel like it was a giant outside reference. But I like this, as I said, I like this team of Liam Neeson and Jaume Collet-Serra. I like Vera Farmiga. So, I mean, I'm inclined to give it the benefit of the doubt, but that was a weak trailer. So I'm curious, what did you think? How many times do you think Liam Neeson can make this movie? And do you think this director looks like he's good enough for Disney and Warner Brothers to fight over? I still say, not quite. Write your thoughts down below, and you can check out some more videos right now.